Welcome to yet another edition of Inside Warhawk Football. Alongside UW-Whitewater head football coach Lance Leipold, I'm Sean Tien. Coach, your team is coming off a narrow 27-26 victory at Platteville on Saturday. What were you most happy with or unhappy with after Saturday's come-from-behind win?
Well, Sean, I thought it was a big win for us, first of all, on the road to battle back. Probably the first thing was the way we fell behind. Mm-hmm. To fall behind 14-0 quickly in the ball game was disappointing, but kind of weather that storm of that first quarter rush that they had and to come back, battle back and get the lead and then hang on at the end. I thought, you know, the way our defense played, especially with the 2-point conversion there at the end, was a huge play.
And now you talk about that 2-point conversion, the Pioneers going for the win at the end. Mm-hmm. Take us through what exactly happened on that play.
Well, they were going to line up for two, then they were going to line up and kick the extra point, but we had a feeling they were going to try to fake it out of that, so we called another timeout, and they threw a route into the corner. The first receiver kind of ran an in route, second receiver went to the end zone, and Ryan Winkman, as his coach, is that he didn't look back, and as soon as the defender put his hands up, he kind of put his hands between it and got a hand on the ball to knock it out and kind of save the day for us.
The savior of the day, indeed. Pioneers quarterback John Kelly orchestrated two quick touchdown drives in the first quarter. He left the game with an apparent injury. Do you know what happened to Kelly at all?
A collarbone injury. It could, I don't know if it's broken or not, but they did say it was a collarbone, and it's the second quarterback for them that has had that happen.
Now, John Kelly, when he went out, Bryce Corrigan came in. The defense, the Warhawk defense, forced three interceptions. What were any adjustments made? Any adjustments to the game plan for Corrigan, or did you stick with the same approach?
I think there were some minor adjustments, but it was just a matter of us settling in, having an understanding of some speed and tempo, what we're doing, and we were able to kind of, like I said, get our feet underneath us, and we got our hands on a couple balls, tipped them, made some plays, and of course with a backup quarterback, sometimes an offense loses its continuity a little bit too.
Offensively, freshman running back Nick Patterson led the Warhawks with over 100 rushing yards on Saturday at Platteville. Very, very good performance by the freshman. What can you tell us about Nick Patterson?
Well, Nick's a very talented young player in our program. He came to us from Sussex Hamilton High School, and his father played here, was a two-sport athlete. Right before I got to school, knew his father well. He was somebody we were excited that came. We thought we recruited a talented group of running backs. He made some early adjustments from playing more of a wing back to being a tailback. Mm-hmm. But Coach Edmonds was very excited about him as he was progressing. And with the injury to Ryan Givens, Nick got a chance. It's good vision. You could see some quickness kind of bursting through the holes. And he really gave us a much needed spark.
A lot to like about Nick Patterson, I'm assuming then. This Saturday, the Warhawks will be hosting UW-River Falls right here at Perkins Stadium. It's Family Fest Day. What do you enjoy most about Family Fest Day? Anything that comes up?
Well, I think it's, obviously our job, anytime there's something like this, I think our responsibility, to the university and to our fans is to try to give them the best game possible that we can play at that time. But in my short time back here, I think it's, if weather's cooperating, right, we end up with a very good crowd, very electric crowd, and that's neat. And it's neat to see families together that are coming to see their children and that, and try to get the experience of what Warhawk athletics and Warhawk football is all about. So it's usually a great day of energy.
What are the keys going to be to the game to defeating the Falcons on Saturday?
Well, we have to take another step in ourselves as a football team, and I think that's offensively continue to progress and find what as we've kind of weathered some of these injuries to find what we can do and do best. I think not turn the ball over. I think coming out of the gates, we sustain a few more drives early on in the game. Our defense continues to play well. Of course, it'll sound like a broken record to you, Sean, but it'll be like, don't give up big plays, don't turn the ball over, don't beat yourself with penalties, and win the special teams battle.
Play smart football. Yeah. That will do it for Inside Warhawk Football alongside UW-Whitewater head football coach Lance Leipold. I'm Sean Tien.